Chris Fair and Elliot Despain will bring the field to green. Eyes on them here off turn four at the cone, setting up on top of the orange, off the white tire. And that's no start. Chase McWhorter out of shape, and he's got a flat right rear tire. And we're getting set to come to green. Eyes on him here off turn four. Green's out. Here we go. Despain going to lead lap one. Chris Fair is second. Eric Sinner's third in the number 98 machine. Sean Thomas fourth. Then it's Wesley Bummett and David Hill. Despain will lead them through once again. Looking nice and smooth. And that C.J. Raven race car had a ninth place finish in the 4,000 to win showdown at Kentucky Lake Motor Speedway in Calvert City, Kentucky last Saturday night. Fair holding down the second spot. Sinners is third. Thomas fourth. And Olay Model second heat. You should be staged. Ultimate Super Late Model Series Heat 1. Super Late Model Heat 1 to staging. As we get ready to roll up to the halfway signal here on this one. And we got a car spun over in turn two, four laps down. Elliot Despain with the field in tow. We'll bring them back to green here off turn number four. Green's out, and here we go. We'll be coming to the halfway signal here. And Sean Thomas spins and may have had some help there. Right here. And we've got some fans standing up outside the wall in turn four. We need you to move, please. Despain shows the way. Fair second, Thomas third, Sinners fourth, and Hill fifth. As we finally get past the midpoint of Pro Late Model Heat number one, Pro Late Model Heat two, they are staged and ready to go. Seven laps in the books, three to go. The field work in lap number eight, and Elliot Despain driving off into the sunset here in this one. He's going to be the first driver to see the two-lap-to-go signal. Two to go on Pro Late Model Heat. One to Spain, the leader, Fair, second. And we've got Thomas and Sinners battling again for third and fourth. Hill is fifth. As the white flag will wave, one lap to go on Pro Late Model Heat number one. And off of turn number four, Elliot Despain will get the win into 75E as Sitter Spence coming off turn two. Chris Fair will come home in second. Sean Thomas will finish third, David Hill fourth. Your top three finishers, third to seven of Independence, Kentucky. Sean Thomas second, the 20 Despain owned C.J. Rayburn race car. Sponsored by Southern Indiana Rock Drilling, Lucas Oil Products, Miller Pest Control, Family Eye Care, Speedy Cal Vinyl Graphics, Walford Signs, Bilstein Shocks, VP Race Fuels, out of Campbellsville, Kentucky. Big round of applause for Elliot Despain. They'll fire at the white chalk line and orange cone. Tyler Allen in the T1 out of Indianapolis, Indiana. The 28 of the insulator, Gary Yeager from Harrodsburg, set to bring him to green here in this one. They'll fire at the line off turn four. Green's out. Here we go. Tyler Allen in the T1. Gary Yeager in the 28. Run first and second. Going to complete lap one. Zane Powell looks to be third. Tom Collini fourth. Then it's Todd Kaufman with a brand new power plant beneath the hood. You remember, blew an engine here 3 weeks ago. O'Connor Mead in the one. Two-time Florence Speedway winner this season. Battling with him back there. That's for the fifth position. As Powell working beneath Yeager for the runner-up slot off two down the back straightaway. Connor Mead from the rear of the field. He's up to fourth and bring Todd Kaufman along with him. He goes to position number five. As Powell going to nose out in front of Yeager and grab the runner-up slot down into turn number one. Good racing action here in Pro Late Model Heat Race number two. Ultimate Super Late Model Heat's coming up. Heats one and two should be staged. Three and four will be on standby. As we get ready to roll in on the halfway signal here. And the halfway signal being shown. Five down, five to go in Pro Late Model Heat number two. Tyler Allen out of Indianapolis, Indiana, shows the way with Junction City Zane Powell in second. Gary Yeager out of Harrodsburg third. But he's got a back bumper full of the one of Connor Mead from Clay City in the 35 of Junction City's Todd Kaufman. Close quarter action right there. Mead to the inside of Yeager. That's for the third spot off two. And put the youngster into the third spot. And Todd Kaufman may have got in there a little too hot, and he has spun the 35 machine down in turn three and four. Caution flag is out. They'll fire at the cone here at the exit of turn four. Eyes on them. Green's out, and here we go. The two-lap-to-go signal about to be displayed to Tyler Allen, the race fitter. Zane Powell second. Tom Collini now up to third. Gary Yeager fourth. And it's Connor Mead, Todd Kaufman, and A.J. Reams. And Tyler Allen working down the back straightaway. You work off turn four. You'll see Jody Rerun Kuntz's white flag. One lap to go here in this one. Allen working down the back straightaway for the final time in this one. Sets that machine down in turn three off of turn four. Indianapolis, Indiana's Tyler Allen, the winner of Pro Late Model Heat number two. Zane Powell will come home in the second spot. Tom Collini will finish in third. Then I believe it'll be Gary Yeager and Todd Kaufman, your top three finishers, third. The 99 of Erlanger, Kentucky's Tom Collini, second, the 28P of Junction City's insane Zane Powell, and the winner of Pro Late Model Heat number two in his own Masters built race car, sponsored by Richmond Guttering, TK Trucking, and Weedon Motorsports in the T1 out of Indianapolis, Indiana. Big round of applause for Tyler Allen.